Yeah, Lee, there is a fair mix of damage out here, starting with power lines sort of scattering across the parking lot out here. Then we see all sorts of sheet metal and wood like this. And then if you look over here, there are even some cars that have their windows blown out from the storm. And then we spoke to one woman who says this maroon car over here, she saw it getting pushed away in the storm. Yeah, Paul, there is all sorts of debris just scattered across this field right now. And electric crews are pretty much out here taking care of these tangled lines. And as you can see, they've already got new poles out here to start putting those up. Now, let's swing over here for a second. Check out some of this damage over here. Now, this trailer over here was pretty much obliterated by the storm. Yeah, Paul, I'm off of Killingsworth Avenue right now. The whole street was hit really hard, roughing up a lot of those power lines. And as you can see, these crews are still out here, been out here all day getting those new poles up and getting those wires untangled. Now, some people were out here and had to take shelter as some of those poles were being lifted up from the ground and thrown into the air.
I was actually underneath those power lines over there, and I was talking to my dad on the phone. And I said, Dad, I've got to get out from under these power lines.
Those lines quickly tangled up after the storm swept through. The poles that held them up ripped to splinters.
And all of a sudden, I could see things flying around and everything.
Metal, wood, and almost anything else caught in the wind took flight, Tanya Wiggins says.
I just hunkered down in the car and waited and talked to Dad, and that's what got me through it.
And just a few yards away, a tire shop now sits covered with broken wood.
We've got a door that goes into our barn back here behind the shop, and I go back there to try to open it up, and it's like it's being, you know, pulled by something else on the other side of it. You couldn't physically open the door.
The shop's back wall eventually ripped right off.
You feel helpless, so we did what we could. We just got down on the floor, covered our heads, and
just outside, Wiggins sat in her car, terrified, as the storm gusted into everything around her.
That car went from one side of the parking lot to the other with nobody driving it. That was just unbelievable. The wind was pushing my car. I could feel the car just going back and forth.
Across the way, the storm obliterated a trailer, practically shredding it into two. Much of that debris sent across a field. Those who watch today's storm unfold are grateful they're able to walk away unharmed with nothing that can't be replaced.
I'm just thankful and very blessed that I get to go home and hug my daughter and my husband.
Certainly a lot of cleanup will take place again tomorrow. As far as those outages go, Southwest Electric is reporting 211 and Liberty Utilities is reporting 239. Those have gone down a little bit. Reporting live in Bolivar, I'm Michael Van Skoik.